Let's get it on.
We don't give a what, we don't give a what.
Get it on the floor, get it on the floor. Get it on the floor, get it on the floor. You don't wanna party, then your ass gotta go. You don't wanna party, then your ass gotta go. And you can ride with this motherfucker, bounce to this motherfucker, freak to this motherfucker.
Let's get it on. Once again, it's the darker nigga, hit a sparker nigga, pick a partner nigga, but the dog is bigger, under stress, doing less, we wanna get blessed to the chest, the slurs from the...
Wrestling fans, what's going on? This is your boy, Mr. Team Breaker, coming from WCC, Wrestling Commentary Central, on this another edition of the Uncensored Conference Show, brought to you by...
Man Boobs.
1-800... No, not Man Boobs. No, but anyway, this show is brought to you by 1-800-COLLECT. Anybody got feelings? Go ahead. You know, that's... You understand? Okay, so anyway, of course, every Monday we talk about Raw, but before I start, I pretty much just want to just let you wrestling fans know about what we do every Monday. Basically, we do what other folks don't do. We keep the shit real. We are not a celebrity, and we're not catering to anybody, whatever, how we feel. We are going to say it on this show. Whether people like it or not, it doesn't really matter. This is our opinion. If you value our opinion, cool. If not, we still are cool with you. But, you know what I'm saying, this is a fan show, so we vent. We bitch, whatever. I mean, if we pay for what we watch every Monday, then that's, we have that right to bitch. You know what I'm saying? So I just wanted to put that out there. But moving on to other news, we just got done watching Raw. And Big Show, he starts it off. He comes out there, bitches, and talks about his debate with Sheamus 2 weeks ago. Big Show basically said that was a big attempt to make him look like a joke. No offense to Big Show, but you're already a joke when you played that movie with you being in them diapers. So then he kept bitching about his 45-second title reign thanks to Daniel Bryan. I'm sorry, Big Show. You still are a joke. I'm serious. Dude, you're a big kid. I mean, dude, anyway, we go on to Big Show. He challenges Daniel Bryan to a match. So it's Daniel Bryan versus Big Show. Of course, this match wasn't going to go on too long. You know, Big Show hit him with a couple body shots, throw him all across the ring and all that shit, you know what I'm saying? And, you know, he hit him with a choke slam and Big Show wins. Really, I really don't know what was the whole point of this. I mean, if he was trying to send a statement, I mean, come on now. This is against Daniel Bryan. Go face. I mean, okay. You know. But, so, then Kane, he comes out there. He seems amused. But then when Big Show is, you know, getting ready to cock him, you know, Daniel Bryan with a, you know, TKO punch, then Kane, he stands in Big Show's way. He's like, you know, I dare you. He does that big brother shit, you know what I'm saying? And he said, hey, try hit me. You know, Big Show, he backs off and then, you know, whatever. So then we come to Punk's decision, quote unquote. This was pretty much a jab towards LeBron James for his quote-unquote decision to go to South Central to take his talents to South Central, quote-unquote. So then Paul talks about this is his 330-day reign as WWE champion. Now, anyone can jump in right now because, to be really honest with you, Punk, to me, is a good champion, but this 300, you know, counting down to the days to 365 days a year, it's really starting to get annoying to me. What everybody thinks about that? Like, do anyone care? Is that relevant? Does it make them irrelevant? I mean, like, what everybody thinks about that?
If it went through some credible people doing this thing, I would say yes. Like, it was like maybe... an attitude era. I hate keep bringing it up because we beat the era to death. But if it was against a whole bunch of good people, then be like, yeah, he had a good reign as a champion. But who has he really wrestled, man, other than, like, Cena, what Jericho came back for a little while. You know, he tried to do his best. You know, he ripped Jericho, don't give a damn no more. You know, so it's like, you know, shit, man, he just, he is who he is, and that's the way he always going to be. He ain't going to get no higher, but he definitely can be to get lower, but he's not going to get no higher. He didn't reach his ceiling, man, is my point.
Okay. Anyone else?
For me, you know, CM Punk, I'm going to agree with some people. He is a good champion, but just for reminding us how many days he has held it, it's pretty much getting on my damn nerves. I mean, other wrestlers who have held the title never bragging about how many days has they have gained the title. Like, you don't see Bruno Sammartino saying, oh, I held it for 4,040 days. He's not going to brag about that. You know,
yeah,
and
even Hogan.
Yeah, Hogan.
You know what?
Didn't
you don't start that Hogan shit because Hogan has really gone under my skin. Please don't do that. You know, with him and his sex tape. Honestly, if that sex tape is like going around, now, dude, keep going.
I was saying. It's just, I think he just should just stop using how many days he has held a title. I think he should brag about it as if he just beat Cena's record. He needs like 40 more days, and he's like even with John Cena.
Which I don't see happening.
Well, depends on like what happens at Hell in a Cell. But so we go on to it's his decision to tell us if he's going to face Ryback or if he's going to face John Cena. And trust me, folks, when we tell you at the end, toward the end of this show, I was shocked, but I wasn't really shocked. But anyway. Shut up. So the Hell in a Cell poster, they also made a comment about the Hell in a Cell poster, which was pretty cool to me. They identified Punk as the devil. If you look at it, he has some devil traits. I mean, really. You know what I'm saying? I mean, got the horns in here, his attitude. It's real hillish. I mean, it's cool. And then, of course, we're going toward Halloween as well. It's around Halloween, I believe, it's on, what, 27th or 24th? Yep.
31st.
Really? Oh, you being funny. Shut the fuck up. Anyway.
No, he's right. He's right.
Are you sure it's on the 31st?
Yeah,
it's on the 31st.
Oh, wow.
It's always on the 31st.
Yeah, always like the last October, don't it?
Yeah.
Not really. I wouldn't have never thought it would land on the 31st. It's not on the 31st. It's on the 24th, ain't it?
No, you're talking about the pay-per-view on Halloween.
Yeah.
No.
Are you talking
about that's what you're talking about. Oh. I thought you were talking about officially Halloween.
Dumb ass, no. Anyway, oh my God. So then, anyway, so now they talk about, you know, Ryback had no business getting in Punk's business or whatever and blah, blah, blah. So then here comes Vince. Vince said that he knew that Punk was going to bitch out and he wasn't going to make his decision. So he told him later on tonight there's going to be a contract signing, and Vince will reveal who will be the person to face CM Punk. Either Kane, I'm about to say Kane. I mean, Cena or Ryback. You know what I'm saying? So stupid. And then Heyman had this, like, stupid-ass look on his face, like, oh, my God, like,
and be mindful that the poster he had covered up was really just a bigger version of the poster he had on screen.
Yeah, exactly.
I wanted to know.
So then we go to the next match, which was Brodus Clay versus Alberto Del Rio. Hated it. Next match. The next match was I don't know if y'all want to talk about this. No, you know what? Fuck this shit. Let's talk about Brodus Clay. All right. So.
He had the darn entrance, man. They gave him the dummy entrance. I mean, the jobber entrance.
I mean, dude, yeah, of course, but are you surprised? I mean, really,
yeah,
bro.
Circle the whole time. Everybody else just got the jobber, you know, entrance when he came in. Now he was the jobber entrance with, you know, just to boost up Alberto Del Rio.
I mean, bro, are you surprised?
But, no, so we do have a blank camera for it, but oh well.
We couldn't see the dancers. They wanted to just get this shit over with. You know, bro, this Clay is, like, really not relevant anymore. I mean, he's not a monster. He's just a dancer that just can't dance.
Hey, we still want to see the doctors, though, man. Come on now.
Nigga, he's a mastodon, dude, and they're treating him like a little cat.
Who cares? I want to see the Funkadactyls, man. That's what I'm
going to Somebody had to replace Big Show.
What do you mean, who had to? Oh, yeah, that's true, too.
He was supposed to replace.
I'm just saying.
Big Show.
No,
I mean, Big Show said he's not going to be the entertainment anymore, so, you know.
And he shouldn't be.
This is the next.
Don't he supposed to be the second and jabbing, dancing?
But this
he's
is the next
and
big
jabbing coon with the K.
Literally.
Exactly.
Next big thing. Literally.
Big things pop up. Anyway, okay, so we go to the next match, which was the Bro Players, Primetime Players, versus Team.
Shannon Stezen. Shout out to Shannon Stezen.
Cobro or whatever. Dude, what's up with that name? That name is like, it just really makes my ass itch. It really does.
What?
It does. It does. Wow. What was it? Team Bro? What was it?
Cobro.
Who?
Homo.
Cobro.
You didn't say no homo?
No. It's Cobro.
Oh, Cobro. Oh, that sounds so...
It was real close.
It was just...
Okay,
it did sound like no homo. Like, okay.
Wow.
Oh, my God. It's, like, hilarious. I swear that should be trending on Twitter right now. I'm so serious. I mean, what happened if they ever did have a team called No Homo? Okay. All right. I'm going to go.
Daniel Bryan and somebody else, man.
So stupid. So, okay. So, the Primetime Players versus Team Cobro. I didn't like this. I didn't like it. Matter of fact, I was too busy cooking tacos. No offense to L, but no, I was in the mood for tacos tonight, so I was cooking or whatever while I was in the kitchen. So,
That was a punch.
No. Because I'm not trying to offend nobody. It's bad enough that someone said that I need to stop eating from McDonald's or some shit. You know what I'm saying? So I'm just like, no offense,
Duncan. I'm offended now. What's wrong with McDonald's?
Oh, McDonald's is for the minorities like me. You know what I'm saying? Like, I got McDonald's across the street.
Look,
dude, if we can use our Quest cards over there at McDonald's, dude, come on. You already know. You know what I'm saying? But anyway.
Oh my God.
But what impressed me about this match right here, it was more so the ending. Titus O'Neil, he did this Clash of the Titan, or Clash of the Titties, or whatever. He did that move. That move reminded me so much of the Lowdown by D'Lo Brown. But this shit had so much hype. I'm like, damn, I know that shit hurt when he fell down to the ground. But, you know.
Yeah, then Kofi called him the human horse face.
What?
You just say the human horse face?
The human horse face? He was barely calling him a horse's ass or some shit. I mean,
Hell no, dude.
Wow, that was disrespectful.
No, that was not disrespectful, bro. What happened if somebody came up to you and called you a horse's face?
Somebody
created. I will call you a horse's ass, dude, if you want to be disrespectful.
Come on, they call D. Brad goat face, and they call Titus O'Neil horse face.
But, dude, he do. Dude, I will call that man because he's a horse. A horse is black. motherfucker got a horse's ass face. You know what I'm saying? I would say that.
You trying to say his snout is big? What are you saying?
Not at all. I'm saying that he's too damn dark. That's what I'm saying.
Man, and it's good that they didn't show that, you know, that, what you call that, Rolling Stone commercial with the big old gorilla with the lips coming out right before the show.
Oh, Rolling Tide, Alabama. No. Let me stop. Anyway, okay. I know I'm going to hell for that one. Okay, so we go to the next match. Ryback versus Dolph Ziggler and David Ortega. Hated it. Next. You already know who won, so why the fuck talk about it? I mean, why talk about it?
It'd be pointless to talk about it.
Yeah, exactly. That's what I said. Like, and then, hold on. David Ortega had the audacity to come out there and say that he deserved. Hold on, I gotta laugh. He said that he deserves a WWE championship match. I swear, if he ever gets a championship match opportunity, I swear I want wings so I can fly all the way to heaven. So anyway, Ryback did win that match, of course. So then we go to the next match, which is the U.S. champion Antonio Cesar Salad versus Jetson Justin Gabriel.
Is there anyone known you say correctly?
Oh, I don't know. What Cerebral Assassin or whatever the fuck. It starts with a C.
It's Cesario.
Oh, Cesario.
He
called him. No. He called him Bizarro, see?
No, it's Cesario. Antonio Cesario.
Oh, Cesario. Nate, you called him Bizarro. That's Cesario. So anyway,
oh wait a minute, remember did y'all notice that USA champ?
Yeah.
For the network or just for
No, they had a USA champ in the middle of the in the middle of the Gabriel.
for the network.
I'm just
saying.
I didn't get the USA channel either, man.
It could have been part of the USA network. I'm trying to figure out, like, why in the fuck are they saying USA?
Was this match Olympic worthy or something?
I don't know. I think they were just chanting USA just to be doing something, to be really honest with you. You know, don't
say Mario says it's a bunch of rednecks in Nashville. They don't know.
Right. I mean, come on now. We're in Nashville tonight. You know what I'm saying?
Oh,
by the way, to Mario, I'm not clowning. Not clowning. I know that you're from Tennessee. I'm not clowning you at all. I'm just saying, there's a whole bunch of rednecks. And they'd be doing shit at random, like chanting USA for like nothing. I'm like, wow.
Oh, we saw the debut of 3MB. 3MB, whatever.
Oh, you talking about the band?
Yeah. Why are we talking about this?
Matt, you talking about talking about Maroon 5, Wannabe.
They're not getting a record deal or nothing.
Good job. 2012.
Wait. That is so much of a mismatch from hell. It is ridiculous.
Hey, can I ask y'all a question though, for real?
Go ahead.
Don't it seem like kind of weird about the band? Okay, you got Heath Slater, but don't it look weird for the other two playing the air guitar on the side of him, and that was not their character from.
Oh, you talking about the foreign people? That's basically what you're saying.
Wait. You got one with a turban doing the air guitar. Then you got one that's brought in as a chosen one, and his best highlight, what everybody said hands down, was the Elimination Chamber was his breakout match. His wife messed it up. He was always vicious. Now he's doing the air guitar. I guess this little skinny little wiener dude.
Hey, anyway, good TV time, bro.
I think that's some foreign coonery going on.
Hey, you know what? You know what's gonna happen though? Heath Slater's gonna get all the credit. Heath Slater's gonna get all the credit for that.
Right, they're gonna get over too.
no, let's be serious about this here for a minute. Hold on now. Like, yeah, you got these three cats who are basically jobbers, but you got to think, you're going to see one of these cats become champion, no doubt.
I know you ain't talking about Wendy's. Okay, because I know he might be able to make some good-ass sandwiches, but he can't do no good-ass matches. Sorry.
Did you call that man Wendy's?
Hell yeah, I called the motherfucker Wendy's. Motherfucker Wendy's is a fucking jobber.
It'll be funny as hell if it get over, just like Ryback.
Ryback? Don't mention that name right now. I mean, really. I'm kind of upset with that man right now.
Why are you upset with Ryback?
Well, I'll get into that later. So then we go to the next match. Matt Stryker versus Kane. Pointless-ass match of the evening. I mean, really. Matt Stryker talked about on last Friday, Kane and Daniel Bryan was having that I'm the tag team champions, I'm the tag team champions debate in the ring. So then Matt Stryker comes in and he asks him a stupid-ass question. Basically he made a statement to Daniel Bryan. He told Daniel Bryan that you are the weakest link on this team. So then Daniel Bryan gave him the no-lock. So then he got up, and then Kane looked at him, gave him a choke slam. So now Matt Stryker comes out there. Right. So then Matt Stryker comes out there, begs it all, trying to talk about he's a broadcaster and not a wrestler anymore and all this other shit. I'm like, okay.
Basically saying he's a jobber now, so like, yeah.
Right. I'm like literally not irrelevant anymore, so can you please like just get on with this?
They just say I'm JTG, man. Look at me.
Right.
JTG.
You know what I'm saying? Wow. I'm like totally not irrelevant. So can you please like beat my ass and get it over with? And I'm not talking about no broke back mountain bullshit either. I'm just saying.
Basically, look at me like I'm JTG.
Pretty much. You already know who won that match, so let's go on. And it wasn't Stryker. Right. So then now we go to Eve versus Layla. Actually, this was a pretty good match for the most part.
You ain't no thing. This is awful chant, though, didn't it?
I don't know. Was it an awful chant?
No, this is awesome.
Oh, this is awesome?
Then he was saying it sarcastically or a bathroom break.
You so stupid. Shut up. Now, before the Divas Championship match, it was a Sheamus versus Barrett rematch. And actually, this match is going to be a world championship match because this match was pretty good.
I told you. Survivor Series for that match. That, you know, that'd probably be a good match to watch anyways.
I agree. Because they put it off, you know, two weeks in a row, and that's kind of saying something, you know what I'm saying? Because, you know, them two was, like, brawling, dude. And Sheamus, he did win, but he Big Show came out there and, you know, interfered in the match. And
he won by disqualification.
Mm-hmm. So then now we go to the Divas Championship match, Eve Torres versus Layla.
When was the Kofi and Miz segment?
Later on the show.
Okay.
Matter of fact, I believe that was like later in the show. So Eve won. There's really not much to talk about. It's just you know, Divas Championship matches like suck ass, but that match was pretty good. But nothing to really talk about. Yeah, it was pretty decent. I mean, I would say so. You know, it was pretty decent. So now we go
on the road as usual. You know,
right. So now we find out that Rey Mysterio had to touch with the flu, and someone called him a pussy in a group.
That's mean.
You know what I'm saying? Said that he got the sniffles. He could have got a touch of that Benadryl in the ring and shit. He would have been all, you know, nice and cozy.
Rey Mysterio had the case. He had
the case. Y'all don't know what we're talking about, my boy, like that.
Shit was hilarious. Motherfucker came out there and called him a pussy. He said, you know, Rey Mysterio got the touch of the flu, so he can't come out today. You know how many motherfuckers have the flu and they still have to work?
I got a case of the sniffles, man. Come on.
Sniffles? Okay, I say hachoo about 3 times and I got to stay at home. Now, what happened if I was a jobber and I told Vince, hey, Vince, I got to stay at home because I keep sneezing all over the time. Get your ass back to work. You know?
Man, you don't believe in no sickness, man.
Look, if I don't got, like, the pig flu, nigga, I'm going to come to work straight up. But, well, I don't know. He probably had the pig flu.
Yeah, that stopped Sin Cara working, too, man. He was like, man, I got to be backstage with JCG, man.
But you're
so stupid.
You
place
wrestling, though.
Well, I mean, I have no comment on that one. You know what I'm saying? I have no comment. So then we go to the next match. Rose Scholars versus the Colon Cleansers with Rosa Martinez or whatever. Pretty good match. That was a good match, too. Rose Scholars did win, you know what I'm saying? They actually dominated that match. I mean, they gave
them
wrestling. Just dog walk them. I mean, shit.
You're walking easy. Like, we got to see these guys gyrate, but we can't see the females gyrate on TV. Come on.
You're welcome.
It is what it is, bro.
So then now we go on to the Miz show. Miz just gave Kofi just like a beating on the mic. I mean, really, he just told
Avery,
Kofi.
Avery, close your ears, Avery.
Kofi is cool. I mean, as far as his in-ring ability, it's average. I mean,
and
don't get me wrong.
He's a nice guy. He's educated.
And that's what pissed me off about Jim Ross. He just kept saying I've never heard him say this in like so many in two paragraphs. He is a nice human being. He is a nice human being, but you know, he keeps losing, but he's a nice human being. He's black, but he's a nice human being. I mean, dude, really?
He has a nice smile, man. So you can't win championship big belt smiling.
Right, but you floss your teeth, but you're a nice human being. You know how many times he said nice human being in the same sense, bro?
Educated and nice human being.
And he's a nice human being because he's trendy.
And educated.
Because he's a nice human being. Because he's
educated.
So where are you really getting at, Chris?
Where I'm getting at is, I'm like, what I'm getting at is, smart ass, is...
I'm not
being disrespectful.
Actually,
the thing about
that wasn't aimed towards you that time.
Okay.
I know you're so used to being disrespectful, but that wasn't towards you that time.
Okay, that's fine. But moving on. My point is to Mr. Sean over there. What was the whole point of saying that shit about Kofi Kingston? Are you pushing him or are you burying him?
Tell him what Miz said to Kofi, man. What did Miz say?
Miz basically said in so many words, you are not relevant. You keep saying boom, 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 but you're going to always be the B, the B-tier wrestler, which was hilarious because it's true.
That was hilarious.
And you know what's so sad about it is that Kofi, you can see in Kofi's face like, man, I wish he would shut the fuck up.
No, I don't want him to shut the fuck up because you know what? It goes back to what Stone Cold said. Yeah, it goes back to what Stone Cold said. As a matter of fact, I wish Stone Cold was Nick McRomney. Remember the motherfucker said that 40%? That 47%, well, half of the 47% in that locker room, it just enjoys being on TV. So what Miz did to Kofi, exactly, he's one of them 47% of the motherfuckers that's in the back that just enjoys being on TV. They enjoy getting that money. You know, and a lot of fans, you know, in WCC didn't like that comments that Miz was making, but it's true.
Kofi been there for 5 years. Kofi been there for 5 years, okay? And I don't want him to be another Mark Henry that gets a title reign 15 years later. And you got broken legs, your balls hurt. You know what I'm saying? Like, dude, go and get your title. I mean, do whatever you got to do to get your title instead of just, you know what I'm saying, like, I think I'm just going to wait back and just get my turn. No, you're not. You're not going to get your turn anytime soon.
Until I said, well, nice guys just finish last sometimes, you know?
No, he said that.
That's some bullshit.
Yeah, that's some bullshit. But you know what? Kofi pretty much sent a loud ass statement to Miz. At the end of the match, it was Kofi versus Miz. Kofi did one of the most sickest Trouble in Paradise kicks I've ever seen in my life. This motherfucker must have been twisting I don't know how many times. He did an Irish rip to Miz, and while he was turning around, dude kicked Miz so hard in the noggin, it was ridiculous.
Man, I bet that was a still shot, man. Real
shot. That was real.
He did that for real.
Hell yeah, dude, did you see how his neck snapped back, dude? It's that such thing as lay it down shit.
That dude was like, he had a concussion.
The motherfucker, man, his mouth was wide open and shit. He was like, like, what the fuck just happened, nigga? You just got your ass kicked, bro. Or got your head kicked in, shit. But Kofi Kingston, and remind you, Kofi Kingston and Miz supposed to have another match on Wednesday in the main event on Ion, Zion, or whatever the fuck that channel
is. So this means Kofi's probably going to lose on Wednesday, but could this be some planting seeds for a main event push somewhere down the line?
It's probably going to be like 15 years from now, like Mark Henry, by the way, but we'll see. So now it's time for the main event. Vince McMahon comes out and makes the decision for CM Punk. Now, anybody can jump in on this because this is open discussion. Okay. So, Ryback, first CM Punk comes out, then Ryback, then Cena. So, by the way it was looking, it seemed like it was going to be set up for a triple threat. But then, of course, Punk is talking. Cena says enough. Then he says you need to get your ass whooped. Say you need to get your ass whooped again. Then start making a promo for Ryback. Saying, you know, one of the three words you're going to be hearing is feed me more. Then he gets out of the ring. Ryback comes to the table, signs his name. That's your winner. Ryback is going to face CM Punk at the Hell in a Cell for the WWE Championship. What do y'all think of that?
All I can say is that table felt dead.
Right, that didn't break.
Oh yeah, and then slam Punk's head on the Jesus.
The table felt dead.
Nigga, the world felt that shit, man.
It was worse than that. Yeah. That bus driver did, man.
I know, right?
Yeah. You know what? I forgot to mention this. In the Antonio versus it's like for some reason we've been seeing a whole bunch of tiger uppercuts like lately. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, sure.
In that match, in a Justin versus Antonio match, Justin went on the top rope, tried to do a high risk maneuver, and then all of a sudden, Antonio does this Shoryuken fucking uppercut, same one that we saw from the bus driver that did to that one bitch that was on that bus that we've all been seeing.
Oh,
even
man.
Better. Now this time this was in midair.
Shoryuken.
Straight up. Just like how that bitch neck snapped back. Just like how was now on duty. It was lights out. Straight up.
Yeah, that was good stuff.
Tiger. Tiger.
Shut up.
You will
So anyway, going back to this.
Oh, Chris, hold on, one more thing.
Whoopsies.
No, this victory. Wow.
Nigga, it's called Toasty.
Oh, yeah.
Toasties.
You know, I always thought they said Sutty. That would have been
good. Do do do.
Toasty. Y'all
stupid. Flawless victory. Fatality.
Friendship.
Babality.
Friendship.
Animality.
Man,
I don't know what was worse. That bitch that got banged, or was it, man?
Well, I'm going to tell you, well, Chris,
no,
I'll tell you this, though.
Bang, man.
I'll tell you this, when I grew up from Cleveland, she on Amazon looking for a new chair right now. I bet she is.
I know, shit. You know how she got shot back like the man?
Hey,
I said, bitch,
hey,
did you lose your chair? I said, bitch,
hey,
did you lose your chair?
He said he did one of them old civil rights uppercuts, man.
That's disrespectful. We shouldn't be laughing about a man.
Wait a minute, did you say eyes on the prize civil uppercuts? Really?
Oh,
is that
wow.
What we own?
No, that was that Rocky uppercut. That's the eye of the tiger.
Not even that Rocky uppercut was as nasty as that uppercut we seen last Tuesday and shit was disgusting, dude. But nah.
You going to hell now? You going to jail now? You going to bow?
Yeah.
Hey,
all right.
Hey.
That's what I'm saying. That's one of them Luke Kane uppercuts and shit. You know what I'm saying?
I'm just saying though. That's why that little yellow and white line is right there. You ain't supposed to come past that.
I'm gonna get my grandson.
She wouldn't even do. She even go past the yellow line. Well, actually, she did.
She was all over the line. If you pay attention to the video, the bus was still moving. She was all over that line. Like, fuck this line. The hell?
Did she spat in his face from what I heard?
Respect
the
gun line, boss.
I'm sorry,
there ain't gonna be no bitch that's gonna spit in my motherfucking face. I don't give a damn if you're female, nigga. I don't give a damn. You spit in my face, nigga. You gonna get that fucking uppercut straight up.
Hey, I bet you before that bus driver, I bet you practice an uppercut like I would you. Like, I wish a motherfucker would not bring a bus pass today.
Nigga, you gonna learn today, right?
You don't know what that man was going through.
You gonna learn today?
He's like, you gonna pay the full fare today, motherfucker.
By the way, her chin is feeling right now. She ain't gonna be able to pay the fare. You know what I'm saying?
Mama, we got reduced fare handicap sign.
Hell yeah, shit. Be sitting right in the front of that damn bus talking about, do you want me to lower the bus for you? Shit, so you can get off. Girl, fly, please let me do it.
Hey, she felt like she was on Mortal Kombat in her heart.
Right. Shit, felt like Kanye West when he got his shit wired. Shit.
That was her word. She got to have a metal plate in that motherfucker.
That was actually
her words.
I think she was a man in real life, though. For real.
They asked her how she felt, and she was like, I felt like I was on Mortal Kombat.
You know what? I want to interview her next time, dude. I'm serious. We take her on Maurice's show, you know, interview her. Like, how do your chin feel right now?
You stupid. But hey, Chris, you gotta do it, Dr. Phil style, though.
Oh hell yeah! Like you know, like when he connected, you know, with his fist to your chin. What was you thinking at that time? Were you thinking like, oh my god, I should have never spit in his face, or did you feel like, oh my god,
this is about to hurt?
Yeah, it's just about to hurt, yeah.
I mean,
can you feel the impact?
I mean, but really, she got, no, that's what she, Yeah, Chinook, that's why she kind of she fell down because it caught her off guard. And see, it didn't knock her out. She just fell.
I'm serious. She one of them next Chung Lee straight up that can just take a beating.
Yeah, because she did took it, man. She went down for a minute, got back up.
And came back on the bus and wanted more. Feed me more.
Then the old man started choking her ass after a minute, though.
He was too busy pulling her weave, straight up.
Some of her weave fell out when he knocked it out. So.
Yeah, man, she had a whole lot, dude. She had some horse hair, bro.
Just got that shit done.
After that Liu Kang uppercut, man, I mean, it's like you could just see like a feather.
Somebody fell out like she was Sonic the Hedgehog, man. Come on.
Man.
Somebody said that the bus driver dodged atmosphere like the boss and uppercut it up in that.
Y'all stupid. But no, going back to Ryback versus Punk. Now, do you think he even a match for Punk? I mean, because like I said, like if you look at it and you see how strong Ryback is, do you think he can actually beat Punk?
No, he's not gonna beat Punk. I mean, he could physically, but he's not. It's not gonna be booked that way.
Yeah, he could. I don't think they're gonna allow that to happen.
Okay, theoretically, if he does win. Does that hurt CM Punk, or does that make him even more vicious? Theoretically, if he did win, could that hurt Ryback, or could that hurt Punk? Which one?
If Ryback wins. My bad.
Who would that hurt more, Punk or Ryback, in the long run?
Well, seeing that CM Punk haven't beat nobody, so it really, so I don't know, cause
man, it would hurt Punk, you know. And then you gotta see where everybody else will fit in line. Like who will fight Ryback? You know, Ryback can't really talk. You know, just.
Yeah, because my thing is.
I think the opposite.
Now, remember, Vince always saw Ryback as a future champion. He had, like, some, I guess, man crush over him since he was Skip Sheffield. He was just waiting for the right time for him to push him up.
I mean, wait a minute. He's loving Ryback because of his man boobs?
Well, he loves big man, big muscles, man.
Dude, that's... Yes, you can talk right now, V-Mac.
Did y'all just call Vince
a gay? No, I'm trying to figure out what's his infatuation with man boobs. I mean, like, really?
He tells David about that little baby oil.
They wrestle in their T-shirts and they tight, and they don't want to show nobody their 36 double D.
Yeah, but David Otunga, baby oil, you know, to rub him down, like, come on.
Okay, David Otunga, you know what I'm saying, he don't got the damn baby oil this week, but so why he ain't getting a title shot? It was kind of unusual how he just came out of nowhere. I mean, dude been on that show for, like, what, 3 years now? He never talked about a damn title shot until now. I was like, oh, you must be online, too. Get the boy baby oil.
I'm just trying to give him some TV time just to feed him right there.
Start to hang around and he keeps going. Hell yeah, he's going to get a shot.
Are you serious? Do you know how whack David Otunga is? Totally irrelevant.
He's out there now, though. You know what, Chris? I would like to be a fly on the wall just to hear how Vince McMahon talks about, like, these men and stuff like that, like, we're bell oil, damn it. No, that's not enough.
Dude, did you see that promo when they was in the back? They was like, you know, Ryback, you know, you you're just so vicious and
so bloody.
Just make me, you know, boom shakalaka. You know?
Oh, God.
You're like this man, rocked
out. I mean, really, he was really getting all hard on because he was like, you're just so masculine in your chest and your clotheslines. It was so wonderful to watch. And then motherfucker gonna talk about feed me puck. I was just so. So then he talk about I'll take your hunger and your lustful punk in consideration.
I hear people talk about that.
It
would kind of scare him.
It was very scary. It was very scary. It was like pedophile like.
They say he's his personal Goldberg, you know.
It's almost some Brokeback Mountain type shit.
It really was, but with muscles.
Yeah. Why are you so officiated on this man's muscles?
I mean, shit, as Vincent Man with this shit. I mean, he is like so engaged with what talk about. Yeah, you just really makes me hot when I just. You know, you're athleticism. You're an unstoppable monster and with big breaths. You know, like
right. Was breathing hard every time he was talking, man.
Right.
Up, you know?
I'm like,
your ruthless aggression.
It's almost Vince was getting a tunnel and an asthma attack at the same damn time.
No, it's like he was getting. It looks like he was getting served up by little Jimmy and
feed me more. What do you mean by feed me more, man? Come on now.
Feed me more.
You talk about feed me more, and you up there heavy breathing, like you're getting hand. I mean, like what the fuck, dude?
Yeah, you want more?
you want more?
Look, if no one, hey, wrestling fans, hey, if you never ever heard Vince McMahon talk so, I don't know, intimately to a muscle man, you should look at that promo he was doing in the back with Ryback. I mean, Ryback was heavy breathing, you know, Vince McMahon was in tune with his sister side, you know what I'm saying? He was talking about, just me, you see my muscles, right?
Hey,
maybe we should go in the back and do some baby oil and shit.
Hey, Chris, I bet you this man felt like Terry Crews off a Friday after next, like,
wow.
Motherfucker Tupac. Goddamn motherfucker.
You are Tupac retarded. Wow, okay. So, this is how I think this is going to, they're going to pull that upset. Now, going into TNA, Bound for Glory was probably one of the best pay-per-views I've seen in since this year.
Man, well, of course, so, Bound for Glory is kind of like WrestleMania. So, it's like, come on.
It was awesome. I ain't going to even lie. So, what the WWE pretty much got to do, and Clint, do not come back in this room no more, okay? Thank you. Because he just left. But anyway.
He coming up in here doing your ideas.
Oh, yeah, he probably is. He probably going back to the whiny, crying, whatever. You know what? I'm going to leave that one alone. I'm going to leave that one alone. But no, I know. But anyway, they probably going to do, like, something that's going to shock us just for, you know. So what y'all think of the pay per view last night? Did any of y'all see it?
I saw it.
Hey, let me tell you something. The pay per view pissed me off because they got a hype running around this world champion. So you know what I'm saying? That just tells me where.
Look, he is a former hype. All right.
Thank you.
Wait, man, who y'all talking about?
Talking about Jeff Hardy.
I'm going to need y'all to step off of Jeff.
And they put Devon in there. He's the most colorful.
So what do y'all think about this? What y'all think about Devon being the leader of Aces and Eights?
I see.
You want to know what I think about it?
Hold on. One time. Go ahead, Fresh.
I'm the tag team champion.
But on a serious note, though,
I think that TNA is at the stage where it's getting stale, so, like, they have to throw you curveballs, Paul. And, like, we all know that Bully Ray can be the heel. So if they would have threw Bully Ray in that spot and had him be the Aces and Ace, it would have been predictable. But you can understand it because Bully Ray is a great heel. But let's see what D-Von can do because the whole time...
Oh, my God. We're talking about D-Von now?
Wait, hold on.
So D-Von's
the leader of the Aces and
Ace?
Yeah, D-Von was the leader.
No, he's not one of the leaders. He's one of the members.
Well, right now, he's the face of Aces and Ace.
No, he's the leader. They did a big reveal for him. So, yeah, if he was just a member, everyone just pulled him off.
No, I don't believe that because I'm sorry. I'm sorry to D-Von. With all due respect to D-Von, D-Von's not smart enough to, like, lead a group. I'm sorry.
I mean, look, all I'm saying is we got to give D-Von. Well, we as fans don't have to, but they want to see what D-Von can do as a major heel.
This man was dressing up like a preacher trying to give Batista some pointers.
But was that his gimmick, though?
Yes, that was part of his gimmick, but his epic fail.
You have to look at it from a rating standpoint.
He's the TV champion and never be on TV.
I mean, you look at it from a rating standpoint, like, at first, TNA was the only thing on TV on Thursday night, but the NFL now does Thursday night football, just like they do Monday night football. So now TNA has to compete with football, which wrestling is so stale, most people rather watch football than watch wrestling. Like, I'll DVR Raw and then watch the football game live because wrestling, it ain't like how it used to be where if I didn't watch it, I felt like I missed something.
Well, of course, you ain't missing nothing when you got a former preacher that's... I'm done. I'm so done.
I mean,
I give it
an A-plus for shock value because, I mean, out of all the people that they threw out there, like Matt Morgan and Jeff Jarrett coming back and, you know, potentially Hulk Hogan or... You know, we're going to bring in John Morrison or Luke Gallows in there for you to unveil the leader and his D-Von. That's like, what? Wait a minute. How? Why? Yeah,
exactly. Like,
This is awkward.
You been with who? Where? You been with who?
Put it like this. They did it for shock value. But what's really going to get you into it and make you believe it is that first promo D-Von is going to cut this Thursday on Impact. That is that's the deciding factor of if the gimmick is going to work.
It's going to be an epic fail, I'm trying to tell you.
You got to cut a promo worth it. Like, you know... You got a damn near go Hulk Hogan from 96 when you tell WWE.
96.
See, dude, that's a hard act to follow, bro. I mean, that's really is. Especially D-Von. D-Von is not exactly good on the mic. I mean, especially motherfucker that has a catchline that says testify. I mean
when they said he was released and he had to relinquish his belt.
But what you're saying is that wasn't him doing these promos when we didn't know who it was? No, it was D'Lo Brown doing them promos, man.
And bang,
shit, that's even worse. He can't even do a promo saying this song.
A good promo, all like, D'Lo promo all depends on when they let, like, depends on where they let him go with it or what kind of guideline they give him. Now, if they give Devon a microphone and be like, you know what, vent your frustrations about everything that's been going on in TNA, I'm pretty sure you can make a good promo out of that, because anybody who's a wrestler feel like we should be top guys.
Wait a minute, who the fuck is firing right now?
Well, somebody turned their fan off, man. Come on now.
Turn your damn fan off. Stop playing with the fan.
That's somebody got their violator through their throat.
Oh, they said vibrator. Like, what?
No, not a vibrator. A violator.
Yeah, it's definitely violating you. No.
Yeah, that,
Anyway, moving on. What you saying, bro?
Look at this Drew McIntyre wearing. I'm sorry, but
looking like a so Triple H, really.
He Slater showed up looking like Willy Wonka. Yeah, I'm out of here,
pal. Willy Wonka.
The 3MB.
Dude.
Devon promo, it all depends on where they let him take it or how they let him deliver it. Because, I mean, if you just sit down and ask anybody, well, what don't you like about your job, I'm pretty sure you can come up with some good stuff about what you don't like about team.
I'm sorry, but
you know what,
it's
Chris,
not doing it for me.
This is going to be the surprise, because you're going to watch Impact and you'll be like, damn, Devon cut a really decent promo. I'll bet you any money you say that.
Wait, you seen the promo?
I might do that, but I just, you know, Devon in the past.
I think Devon is going to shock Chris, because right now Chris has no faith in Devon.
Hell no, I don't. I just don't. I really don't.
Man, anybody has to have faith for him to be the big reveal, though, so.
Yeah, because, like, it's like, Devon is somebody who you think has no talent whatsoever on the mic.
Wait
a minute. You said we think?
Bitch, though. Come on.
We know this.
Right. You know this. You know.
He proved it himself.
Hell yeah. He talking about I'm a failure. My sons know that. Nigga, we know. Shit.
I'm not low key. If you take Devon's career in TNA since they split up Team 3D, he has got a lot of shit to say. Like,
hell yeah.
You give me the TV title? Yeah, I'm never on TV. Then you team me with Eric Bischoff's son. Really? This guy sucks.
Well, you bear off giving Kofi Kingston that damn spot, nigga.
Then I tell y'all, I don't want my kids involved in this. And what do y'all do? You bring my kids in. Like, he's got a lot to go off.
Right, and wasn't Butch Collar banging his wife, too, you know?
Kofi Kingston could not cut a promo if Stone Cold wrote it. I'm sorry.
But, yeah. I agree. I concur. I really concur.
No, especially when you put him against somebody that can, man. It really hurt Kofi.
Yeah, it really hurt him tonight, because, I mean, if you want to talk about a person's story of being irrelevancy, you felt it tonight.
It was Kofi. I mean, he said, you're right. Even when he co-signed, you're right.
You're right. I haven't been shit, and I never will be shit. That's basically what he said in so many words.
He can't say never will be. He just say he haven't been in 5 years. So,
in 5 years and 6 years, it's going to be 16 years. He talking about
right,
being here for 16 years.
And even JR kept talking about he had flashes of being great when he fought Randy Orton years ago.
See, that's fucked up when they talk about you got flashes. That's just wow.
Flashes of that it factor. That's the only time Kofi ever had any type of on mic skill, but that was it. That was his shine.
But they were saying that was the only time he showed aggressiveness. He said, you got to be more aggressive. Can't be happy-go-lucky and smiling and having faith at Jamaican accent.
Exactly. I mean, you could be a good human being and still whoop some ass. I mean, for real. You can't be just smiling around and thinking, oh, yeah, I'm going to give me a title shot. It doesn't work that way, Kofi.
Yeah, you can't just be saying boom, boom, boom to win the world championship.
Yeah, because you go boom, 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 your ass on this. It's going to be like 16 years, and then you're going to be looking like D'Lo Brown and And Mark Henry with no neck.
Boom, boom, boom. On the third 24-second championships runs. You
yeah,
know?
Yeah, because boom, boom, boom is going to be on the unemployment line in a few.
Oh, no.
Chris. Boom, boom,
boom. Boom, boom, gone. Now, was that towards me this time? Shit.
Yeah, that was the only person talking. It's yours.
Oh, okay. All right, thank you. Thank you for them disrespectful props. Appreciate it.
Look at this. WC2 World, do you see this?
Wait, what did Kofi
Can you hear this?
No, Kofi Kingston was totally disrespected to that. No.
And Kofi had that stuck face when Mill was speaking the truth, man.
Yeah, he had, he's like, was totally spent. Like, I can't believe you're saying this to me. Like, how dare you, Miz? Nigga, he's telling you the truth. You need to boom, boom, boom your ass on getting some damn title shots. I mean, world championship matches.
He said,
man,
boom,
but it would have been bigger if CM Punk was, if it was going for the world belt or the WWE belt, like, the storyline would have been better. Like, you never could win this big one.
But then, yeah, you getting these low-ass tier belts, you know what I'm saying, the Intercontinental Championship and the U.S. title. I'm like, dude, like,
tag team championship.
Yeah, and then they call him, like, you know, another. He said, you just keep going from tag team to tag team. Like, first you got Evan Bourne. He left you. Then you got the dude with the million voices.
Man.
So yeah, and he left you. I'm like, damn, nigga, he just
the
going
drug
ham
addict,
on you.
And then you got the guy that's seeing imaginary white boys. Come on.
Don't give up. CM Punk definitely left you.
He said imaginary white boys. That is funny.
But you see, Jimmy. Jimmy's not black on no T-shirts, man.
Yes, he is. He is black. Look, little Jimmy is black on the outside.
Wait, little Jimmy might have a few pimples now. He's going through puberty.
Hey, honestly, Chris, I would love to see you interview little Jimmy.
Not at all. Do you think a black man like me, of my stature, was going to interview somebody that's, like, totally invisible? No, I don't think so.
I mean, you interviewed. Never mind.
Exactly. I think you should say never mind.
When did that happen?
Huh?
I'm gonna stop. Okay, I'm done.
Yes, please. No, what you say, Fresh?
Fresh watching this show.
He's skimming through DVR watching.
skimming through a DVR. Okay.
Trying to catch up.
No, okay. So then, too, everybody. Ryback has some comments for. Bill Goldberg said that he's better than Bill Goldberg. What y'all think about that?
Wow.
That's what I said. I said, wow.
Is that Goldberg's way of finding his way back?
Yes. Very.
It was just starting something. Like when somebody asked MVP, said, did you train right back? He said, no. If I trained him, he could actually wrestle.
Damn.
Yeah, he did say that. You're right.
Damn.
He still did say that, though.
That's kind of fucked up because Ryback cannot wrestle whatsoever. He got like two or three movesets.
You don't have to wrestle to be in the main event. He just proved that to you.
No, you're right. He did prove it. He got man boobs. He looked like another Bill Goldberg. And he says, feed me more.
So who is the Miz to really read somebody that writes like he's done anything relevant in wrestling?
Well, they're just saying Miz.
He did. I'm gonna tell you this: Miz did more than Kofi Kingston have done in a lifetime.
Right.
I mean, let's keep it real.
Do you really?
The goal of WWE is to headline WrestleMania and win WrestleMania as the champ. Like, come on.
Even though he himself was totally irrelevant because they totally ignored him in the storyline.
Even CM Punk was jealous of. He said, "Man, Miz is the main event. I'm not."
And you know what though? If you look at and if CM Punk, and like, and I understood his frustration after watching his DVD, but if he really looked at the build up to WrestleMania, he should have been happy that he wasn't in that spot, because Miz totally got overshadowed by the fact that The Rock came back. Rock hosting WrestleMania, and then Rock is picking up this beef that Cena started about 5 years previous from a comment he said to a reporter. Miz was just there because he was a champ.
See, if Kofi was smart enough, he could have used that to his advantage. He said, yeah, you could have been in the main event, but you was totally irrelevant through the whole entire storyline. He could have said that.
I'm
not gonna let some worm try to.
Happen. You got to be the good guy, Kofi. You can't speak your mind out here.
Shit, bullshit. Exactly. If Wesley could speak his mind, shit. Fuck that shit. If this motherfucker gonna sit up here, he gonna say to me that my career haven't been relevant since God knows like 2009 or whatever. So let's talk about you. You had the WWE Championship, and no one still cared about your ass. And then yet, you go to WrestleMania, they still don't care about your ass. Matter of fact, they was booing you in your match. But that would have been me. That's just critical thing.
Yeah, if you're talking about, man, you're getting too close to CM Punk, it's like, well, who was more irrelevant, Miz or Punk?
Damn.
Miz could say, well, shoot, y'all are more relevant in 4 months than Punk was in 330 days.
Is it me or does Kofi Kingston look like a low-budget Theo Huxtable?
Very much so.
He looked like RG3 for some reason.
No, he had it right. He does look like a low-budget Theo Huxtable. That's fucked up. That's fucked up. I didn't even see it that way. I should tweet that.
I don't even tweet it.
Eat some pudding pops. Boom, boom, boom.
Boom, boom your ass on getting some titles.
All y'all can wait for the Hell in a Cell pay-per-view. I personally don't care because just 2 days after that, only the greatest game in the history of the franchise will be released that Tuesday. So, yeah.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
And I just seen the DLC content.
And what game are you talking about, my friend?
WWE 13.
WWE 13.
All right.
Like, the Attitude Era DLC is so vicious. The current roster DLC is so vicious. Oh, man. Like, if we can't relive the Attitude Era through TV, we might as well do it through video games. And that was the best thing that could ever do.
And that's the only time you're going to see CM Punk and Stone Cold go at it.
Wow,
and
that's
just... And I'm okay with that.
I'm not. I mean, I can play 365 days a year. I want to see some in live action.
It's not gonna be the same. Like, you can't have CM Punk of 2011 wrestling Austin of 2011. Austin ain't wrestled in like 6 years, man. It's not gonna,
that way you can have the prime and kind of Austin in his prime in the video game. He's not hurt. You know, two bad knees, bad.
Yeah, and even if he did, and even if he does get dropped on his head, it's gonna be brand new.
Right.
Like, if you take, like, if you could get Stone Cold from like 97, 98 versus CM Punk of like this year, last year, it'd be epic.
Please. But I am looking forward to WWE 13. I can't wait to play that motherfucker.
But Austin still cut a good promo, man. Like, him missing stuff.
Oh, hell yeah. He was really... I mean, he was really disrespecting the people, you know, the guys that's, you know, on the roster right now. He said,
that's
I could just, like, kill him
true.
In two moves, and it's a wrap. Like, damn.
That was true. That's true. And I was saying, Ziggler would sell the stun in the bus.
No, he was talking about, you know what I'm saying, the band. He was talking about, you know what I'm saying.
Everybody. He only said the only competition would be Cena and Punk. Everybody else, wham, stunner.
Damn, even Sheamus?
Sheamus, irrelevant, man.
Wham, stunner.
Sheamus is irrelevant? Sheamus is like one of the best workers there. Well,
fucking irrelevant.
But yeah, they're irrelevant. Yeah. But anyway,
I mean the Big Show. I mean, like you know, I mean, you'll like to see it, but still irrelevant.
Big Show is a joke. He's been a joke since he got to the WWE.
No, I ain't gonna say that. I ain't gonna go that far.
No, I would go that far. I mean, really. Mommy, look, Big Show, he's an entertainer, but when it comes to, like, people taking him serious, it's like...
I mean, he had his moments, you know, throughout the years.
Of course. Like, breaking the ring, that was one of his good moments, yeah.
Yeah, he pushed that car on Hardcore Holly. I mean, because... Wrestling,
Undertaker do the ring, you know. Yeah.
I mean, when Big Show works his best when he's a heel. He can't be a face because of the face, he becomes a joke. Can't be a face, he has to be a heel.
Especially when you're wearing diapers. Yep, I get you.
I mean, Big Show. I mean, his career don't really mean nothing no more. But you know.
No.
But yeah, Hell in a Cell is a throwaway pay-per-view, and they're saving Cena for Survivor Series.
So it looks like we're supposed to be getting ready for Survivor Series and just skipping Hell in a Cell.
Yeah.
I mean
Survivor Series is when we finna get all the good shit. You know, I just think we're supposed to be back on TV by Survivor Series. We should get an epic CM Punk Cena match by Survivor Series. I heard Brock's supposed to show up. So, you know, Cena's injury was a blessing in disguise. It kind of helped elevate, you know, other people.
Yes, it was a blessing for me. I'm so glad.
Otherwise, we wouldn't stop CM Punk and Cena for the next four months.
I don't have to see here. I'm like, dude, okay, all right.
I mean, in a way, it's a blessing, but in a way, it's not. Like,
nigga, please. It's a fucking blessing all the way around because we don't have to see no damn, the skittle. We don't have to see.
Look at this. Look at it like this. I don't see CM Punk dropping the belt to Ryback at Hell in a Cell.
Of course not.
Okay.
It's a throwaway pay-per-view.
How? How do you put it together where CM Punk doesn't lose his belt, Ryback still looks good, and he doesn't lose? Because if it's a one-on-one,
right,
he's not going to lose clean.
I mean,
if I was them, I would write the storyline where CM Punk says fuck it and runs away. Like the entire match, CM Punk is trying to find a way to escape the cage. He finally gets out and he hauls ass. And when I say haul ass, like he runs. And he runs out of the building. That's how the pay-per-view ends.
Yeah, because you're thinking, like, he can't get DQ. He can't get counted out. It's a hell of a thing.
So the only way to escape is you have to leave. That way everybody stays safe.
I have another opinion.
You have a low budget match on Raw, and Ryback loses in a dirty match, and everybody's happy.
No, I don't think that would happen.
Okay. So like we were talking about this earlier. What happens if Ryback does win? Does that bring shock value?
Yes, it does.
Yes, it would. But
what percentage do you think? Ryback have a chance of winning the WWE Championship in
1%?
30%.
I don't know. Do we want a Goldberg effect?
I mean, we're having a Goldberg effect already. I mean, what the fuck? We have an RVD and a Goldberg effect. I mean, shit.
Because Goldberg beat Hulk Hogan on a Nitro and still wasn't the fucking main event of anything.
because Goldberg is a crybaby, dude. I mean, really.
Yeah.
But at the same time, the guy he beat wasn't a champion for 330 days or how many days he's going to be by the time Hell in a Cell comes up.
No. Hulk Hogan was an old fossil.
Wait. New newsflash, Hulk Hogan is the biggest name in fucking professional wrestling, no matter how long he was champ.
Mm-hmm. And how many times that he was selling his sex tapes as well.
Wow.
No, he's suing old boy for putting out there. Saying,
bullshit.
Oh, I did not know.
He
I did not know the camera was over there.
He's trying to discreetly talk about don't tell nobody about these sex tapes, you know what I'm saying? Then it got leaked out. And they said that Hulk Hogan was like almost having a heart attack. I'm like, ooh, wow.
What are you talking about during the actions or something about the leak?
That's like his skin is falling off. Like,
the hairline went down even further, so. The bonus is real, brother.
I'm done. Anyway, everybody, thank you for coming on the show. Tune in for tomorrow with Sean and L for the Unload Show. Overload Show. WCC Overload. Then also on Wednesday. Shut up. And then tune in to Wednesday with Maurice for Rumbling with Reese. And then also on Thursday, tune in with Ro for the Recipe with the TNA Show. And then we'll be back next Saturday for WCC Overload. Again, I'm sorry. That was breakdown, actually. I'm sorry. I'm getting my shit messed up. But anyway, I'm tired as fuck. We'll see y'all next week. Adios, amigos. Deuces. Have a good night.
Me more.
Bye.
Heidenreich. Heidenreich.